number 10 of Alex Trushinski from Greenbush. And last but not least on row six by his lonesome, Chris Unruh from Winkler, Manitoba. Total of 11 cars in the Lightning Sprint class. Should be a dandy. Now this Winnipeg Free Press Lightning Sprint class getting ready to go. They're going to get 15 laps on the AIE communications board. And this is one of the fastest classes you'll find here at Red River Co-op Speedway. Darren, you race these Lightning Sprints. They're pretty quick, aren't they?
They are actually, lap time-wise, the fastest cars that we race here at Red River Co-op Speedway.
And they had made a major change a few years ago with the engines that they were running. They went from a smaller engine to a much larger, correct?
Absolutely, they did. They were running a 1,000cc motorcycle engine. They turn about 14,000 RPM. They make 185 horsepower, and the cars only weigh 950 pounds with drivers. So these little cars fly.
Wow.
Full-size midgets with wings. One of our featured drivers, Robert Livingstone, in the lead, but now battling down the back straightaway. We've got ourselves a great race here in the Lightning Sprint division. Alan Trushinski out of Greenbush, Minnesota, showing the way, but we've got a yellow flag. All right, that'll bring out a yellow flag. With one lap down, 14 to go on the AIE communications board. Well, that caution, of course, was for the number four. That is Eric Johnson out of Grand Forks, North Dakota. Well, there's two major chassis builders involved, actually three, Foz chassis, also Henchcraft chassis, you'll see a lot of those, and Bailey chassis out of Tennessee. These are built to full World of Outlaws specifications. They have 4130 chromoly chassis. Everything on these cars is aircraft quality. The cost for a brand new Lightning Sprint these days with engine, probably in about the $22,000 to $25,000 range. They run a 16 square foot top wing. They run the original six-speed motorcycle transmission. Now they'll only shift once during a race, coming out of turn four when they get the green flag. Most of these guys will race in third gear, so they'll shift gears coming out of turn number two, or rather out of turn number four, shift out of gear number two into gear three, and that will be their race gear. Some elect to slip the clutches to get their speed up, but that's a little tough on clutch parts, so. But 185 horsepower in a 950 pound race car is phenomenal, and that's what makes these things go down the racetrack so quickly. The driveline is a motorcycle chain, a 530 motorcycle chain, to a solid rear axle, and of course they run staggered rear tires just like their World of Outlaws brothers to get them through the corners. Once again, Alex Trushinski goes to the bottom of the racetrack looking good, but here comes the HVAC group number two of Roland Bernard. This is only the second time the Lightning Sprints have appeared here in Winnipeg this year. Roland Bernard won the first race, and we've got trouble. Ed Bell getting tangled up with Chris Unruh in the 27 car at the top of turn number four. Both cars refire on their own. These cars are self-starting, unlike a World of Outlaws sprint car that needs a push start. They do use the motorcycle transmission, as I told you. They also use the motorcycle clutch, so they just put it back in neutral or squeeze the clutch, hit the starter button, fire up, and go. All right, so Trusinski will be your leader on the restart. Just two laps in this lightning sprint feature as a result of some spinouts here on the racetrack. Looks like the 27 car of Chris Unruh will be ready to go once again. All right, we should be one lap to green now here in the lightning sprints. Website address is nlsprints.com on the web. Always cars for sale and information on the lightning sprint class. Ed Bell will tail the field in the 14 car sponsored by Winnipeg Moving and Bell's Property Services. Green flag is out, here we go. Keep your eyes on the Ward Trucking HVAC group number 2 of Roland Bernard. Livingstone battles back now and gets a good drive in the Treherne number 43. Look at Livingstone go, one of our featured drivers, and wow. The Treherne collision in glass 43 looking strong here. Here comes the HVAC group number 2 of Roland Bernard side by side. Look at the battle as they head out of turn number 4. While a pair of Henchcraft chassis battling at the front of the pack now, Roland Bernard in the HVAC group number 2 goes around the outside, and he is working on his second feature win of the year. Nine laps remaining on the AIE communications board. Wally Butler riding along in the third spot in the 35W. Robert Livingstone has dropped to fourth. The direct by number 1 of Chris Soren, now fifth, getting by DeVergston. Best race in the place for fourth, fifth, and sixth. Roland Bernard to the top of the racetrack, and Trusinski takes back the lead. Wow. It looked like Bernard was gone, but apparently not. Wally Butler in the 35W now beginning to move up on second place, Roland Bernard. Chris Soren on the move in the direct by car number 1. Three laps to go. Can Roland Bernard make up the ground and pass back Alan Trusinski?
Oh, it's gonna be a close one, Darren, and we got a car in the front. We've got a yellow flag as the 4 is out in front at a stop. Eric Johnson from Grand Forks, North Dakota, having some problems tonight. And things are gonna get interesting in this one. So make sure you keep in touch, ladies and gentlemen, with what's going on here at Red River Co-op Speedway. Check out our website at www.redrivercoopspeedway.ca, where we have all of our race schedule plus our driver information. Want to know more about what's going on, what's coming up, and our sponsors? Check out our website. So the number four of Eric Johnson from Grand Forks is getting pushed off the track at this point in time. We're gonna get those drivers back in order now as we get ready to finish off this race. They're gonna put three laps up on the board. So your order in this one, it's the 13T of Alan Trzcinski from Greenbush, followed by the number 2R of Roland Bernard from Winnipeg, the 35W of Wally Butler is in third spot in this one so far, the number 11 of Dexter Dvergsen from Greenbush, he's going to be in the fourth spot. The 43 of Robert Livingstone is going to be in the fifth spot in this one as we get restarted, followed by Chris Sorn, the 33 car of Murray Temple. This is going to be a fun finish to this race as our leaders were going back and forth just before we have the yellow caution. One to green as we get ready to go.
One to go.
As the cars come around turn three, Como's looking them over. He's giving them the green flag and we are racing. The 13T goes low, the two goes high. Roland Bernard now making a push on the backstretch. They're door to door. 13T having some problems trying to stay in control. Oh, we've got a pile up there as Wally Butler gets tagged going into four. Wally Butler looks like he's all right in this one. He's gonna move back with the pack. So if you're a fan of the Lightning Sprints, this is their second race of the season here at Red River Co-op Speedway. They will be back though, don't you worry. They're here plenty of times this season. Their next time, well, is on July 9th as they get ready here to race for a regular Thursday Night Thunder at Red River Co-op Speedway. That's just before the big truck show that weekend. Three exciting nights of action on the 9th, 10th, and 11th. We have Thursday Night Thunder followed by the two Monster X Tour shows. And Butler now gets the opportunity to take the second spot, and guess who's at the back? Yeah, the guy that had a chance to win this race at one point. The 13T of Alan Trzcinski now is at the back of the bus. Looks like we're ready to go on this one. Cars getting closer together as they go around turn number four. Rob Cohen once again looking them over. We're green flag racing. I'm too excited. This is going to be a great finish. Oh, and Bernard goes flying around the pack. The fight right now is for third spot between the 43 of Robert Livingstone and the number 11 Lightning Sprint at Dexter Dvergsten. Now Chris Soren soaring ahead at the top of the track. He makes his way around and tries to grab a hold of third spot. White flag in this one. Your leader is the two of Roland Bernard. He's got this one wrapped up. Your winner tonight, driving the 2R, that's Roland Bernard. Second spot goes to the 35W of Wally Butler. Third goes to the one of Chris Soren. It looks like the 43 of Robert Livingstone ends up with fourth spot. And the number five spot looks like it's going to be handed to the number 27 Lightning Sprint. That's Chris Unruh from Winkler, Manitoba. What a great race for Roland Bernard in his 2R Lightning Sprint. And he's coming around the front stretch. Your winner tonight, he is driving that 2R car. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Roland Bernard. Well, we're going to throw it down to Darren Palin now, who's going to interview our winning driver for this evening. Darren?
Thanks very much, Ken. We're just going to give Roland Bernard a chance to get his full harness off, his Hans device and his helmet. Of course, these cars are very small in cockpit size, and they resemble a full midget that you'd see that would run at the Chili Ball in Tulsa. They are a full midget chassis with a motorcycle engine instead of a four-cylinder midget engine, and of course they run that 16 square foot adjustable wing up top for aerodynamic purposes. Rolling almost out of the car now, he runs a Suzuki GSXR 1000 engine. We told you earlier they are about 185 horsepower at the crankshaft, so plenty of horsepower, and boy, they are reliable engines, no doubt about that. There he is. How about it, Roland Bernard, your winner? Well, Roland, congratulations. A fantastic job. You had a battle with Trasinski there, and he spun. You outlasted him.
Yeah, we were overheating a little bit there towards the end. I had to woo up a little bit, but I figured, well, we're going checkers or wreckers, so we're going to blow that baby up if we had to.
Well, it's been pretty reliable. Second shot here this year and second win. You got to be happy with your team's performance.
Absolutely. The competition every year gets greater and greater, and a shout out to those guys for putting the pressure on. We tried some stuff. It worked. I really want to thank my crew chief, Mark, for being out there, and here he comes. So. Thanks.
How about a Roland Bernard, your winner in the Lightning Sprints? We're going to go back up to you now, Ken, with more action.
Thank you, Darren. Castrol is a proud sponsor of Red River Co-op Speedway. We are passionate about racing and want to help you make